Welcome you to the 2016 Grandparents Day at Lipscomb Academy Elementary School. The school was called Lipscomb Academy Elementary School, the Burton campus, for quite some time. Until about 4 years ago, we changed the name to the Brewer campus. And that's named after Nika Brewer Stevens. And Nika, I've invited Nika here today. She's one of our special friends. And she has a long history with this university and this academy and this campus. And she's going to tell you just a few things in way of welcome. And then Mr. Greg Glenn is going to speak to us just for a moment and pray over us. Before I do that, though, there's some white cards on your chair. If you haven't had a chance to fill one of those out, that's just to keep up with current information. Our advancement office needs to make sure that we have the current information for you. And at the end of the performance, we're going to draw one of those white cards and give out a gift basket. Glad you're here. It's going to be a great show.
Hi, everybody. I can do this. Yeah. It's great to be here with all of you. It's an honor to serve as one of the trustees for the academy that serves your grandchildren, your children. There's something you may not know about the trustees that I want to share with you. This is a prayer card. At the beginning of each year, the university students, the graduate students, and the academies are each listed alphabetically. Then each trustee is given three cards, one for the academy, one for the university, one for the grad students. These are our prayer cards. Mine, this is my last year's card. This year's card starts with Alex Godowski and ends with Brooklyn Lowry. I have the opportunity to pray for your special student if they fall within those letters. It's something that's very meaningful to me, and I hope it is to you, to know that the trustees are praying for your student by name. It reminds me of something that I heard a quote from the beautiful and very wise Gloria Gaither. Gloria says that Satan gives you a label. God gives you a name. Some of you may have been at the Grandparents' Day for the high school and heard me speak then about David and Maggie Lipscomb and James A. Harding and the history of the school. I don't want to repeat myself, and I couldn't if I wanted to, but I thought today I would center more on the roots that we represent right here in this room. How many of you have grandparents that were part of the Lipscomb family? If you'd raise your hands, if you had grandparents that were schooled here. Okay, quite a few of you. How about parents? Your parents were part of the Lipscomb family. And of course, all of you are part of the Lipscomb family now because your grandchild, your child, your loved one is here. We are the roots of Lipscomb. As Jonathan said, I claim that. My history goes back 125 years. I'm not quite that old. I'm close to it. Your children think I am. When I tell them I know David and Maggie Lipscomb, they believe me. But we are the deep, deep roots that sustain that institution that is nurturing your beloved child. There are others of you who don't have that long history with Lipscomb. You are those who are grafted in and add so much new vitality, life to our school. You're so necessary. We need both. We need the history of the institution. We need the new people that come in. I think of the Lowrys still as the new people who came in here because it was 11 years ago. That's before some of your children were born, but they're still new and they've added so very, very much to the Lipscomb community. Where am I? I spoke of my family and the generations that I have, 125-year history here. That makes me fourth generation. Our fifth, our sixth, and even our seventh generation of our family are represented on campus now. They are those seventh generations are the young and tender ones that went in preschool. That we have the opportunity, you have the opportunity to embrace and to nurture and to grow in their faith and knowledge of God. There's one scripture I want to quote from Colossians, verse 2. Chapter 2, verse 7. Let your roots grow down deeply in him, and let him build you up on a strong foundation. Be strong in the faith, just as you were taught, and always spill over with thankfulness. We spill over with thankfulness for you, for being here, for loving us, for supporting us, for being part of our family. Thank you. We wish you the happy Christmas.
Thank you, Nika. My name is Greg Glenn. I serve as head of school here at Lipscomb Academy, and I also want to join in with Jonathan and Nika and welcome you all here. On behalf of President Lowry and our entire Lipscomb family, we're excited that you're here at Grandparents Day. And so let me just say to you real quickly, as Nika has shared just some great history, and we have much to be thankful for, you're getting ready to see a lot of the reasons we're thankful for come up here and perform here in just a few minutes. But I just want to take 1 second to say to you that the kingdom education that takes place here on a daily basis would not be able to take place without the commitment to that Christian education that you all perform as grandparents. Very, very thankful for each child that we have here at Lipscomb Academy and for those that have gone on after that. Also very thankful for our faculty that are not only immensely professional in what they do, but tremendously passionate in the way that they carry out that mission. But I want you all to know, as grandparents in particular, this afternoon, we really appreciate you. We wouldn't have a chance to be nearly the quality of school that we have without you all. And we recognize the commitment that you have and for your grandkids, for your children and grandkids. And I'd like to hear some more stories like Nika's going down into the seventh generation about keeping that going. So again, I just want to thank you. I'm going to open us up here with a word of prayer and we'll get started. And again, just thank you for being here with us this afternoon. Let's pray. Father, we come to you this afternoon very, very thankful. Father, we're thankful for knowing that every blessing we have comes from you. And Father, as we come into this season where we get to get out of our routines and focus more on those blessings, Father, help us to keep our eyes focused on you. Father, we thank you for the precious children that are getting ready to come up here and perform, and just ask that you continue to bless them, bless us as adults as we try to raise them up to be warriors for you. And just, Father, we're thankful for the opportunity we have to be here at Lipscomb. And Father, we ask that you use us to whatever way brings you honor and glory, and thankful most of all for your son Jesus. And that's the reason for this season. It's his name we pray. Amen.
helping, caring, helping, sharing. Christmas comes from the heart.
Giving, receiving, loving, believing. Christmas comes from the heart.
Let us rejoice.
Good afternoon. I'm Katie Clayton, one of the fourth grade language arts teachers. Over the last few weeks, we have been studying poetry, and students have been working hard writing their own poems. One of their poems was themed Grandparents, which covers a lot. Some of their poems are funny, some of them are sweet, and some of them are quite tender. One thing is for sure, fourth graders love and adore their grandparents. A few poems have been selected to be shared with you today. Our readers are Weston Lowry, Addie Couts, Danny Vance, Luke Jackson, Ellie Taylor, Cassie Callis, and Mary Catherine Hall.
In my grandmother's house, there's a piano. Where I go to play the songs I know, where the elf just sits there and watches me. When I walk in, it is the first thing I see. It has a window that shows light on the whole thing. When you play it, it feels like you're in a different world where nobody is watching you. I also wonder how it got there. Was it passed down? It makes me feel really joyful. It sounds like no other. It sounds like no other. It sounds like no other.
Grandparents, I like them. Ask me why. Because they tuck me in when they come to visit. Because they tell me stories from their childhood. Because they cook big, delicious dinners. Because they pick me up from school. Because they bring gifts for us all. Because they play games with us. Because they cuddle up with me when we watch a movie. Because they love Jesus and me. Because, that's why I like grandparents.
Thank you. My grandparents love the Lord, and God's mighty word is their sword. They love God with their whole heart, and they never wish to be apart. They serve others and love them too. If you met them, they'd love you.
Grandparents, I like them. Ask me why. Because they help me with my homework. Because they have an awesome new computer. Because they love and care for me. Because they always have popsicles at their house. Because they're always there when I need them. Because they don't care if I'm too old for a hug and a kiss. Because they're there to pick me up when I'm down. Because they have a big backyard. Because. That's why I like grandparents.
Thank you. grandparents. Grandma, these are a few reasons of why I love you. You love to cook for me. You are like a million stars over my head, protecting me. The most important reason why I love you is that you love God. Grandma, this is why I love you.
Grandparents, I like them. Ask me why? Because they love God. Because they love me. Because they play with me. Because they care for me. Because they do things for me. Because they show me things. Because they teach me things. Because they're always there for me. Because. That's why I like grandparents.
When I walk in, the sweet smell of lasagna fills the house. Great feelings of joy, happiness, and cheer spread the room. We laugh the whole day away. Thank you.
Frozen in the snow lie roses sleeping, flowers that will let go the sunrise.
Fire of hope is our only warmth. Weary its flame will be dying soon.
That was beautiful, wasn't it? We have one more song for you. We have heard about, we've heard poetry and scriptures and songs about Jesus like we just heard, Christmas carols. And then there's one more number that these guys are going to sing for you. And then we're going to give them a rousing ovation that they're going to remember in just a moment. This is going to be a fun song. Thank you. Great job. You guys did a great job. You guys can take a seat. There's a few people I'd like to thank before we're dismissed. ETS and event management really transformed this gym into a performance space, so I want to thank them. So let's give them a round of applause. Lucy Seiferth here on the piano, and our strings teacher, Bailey Warner. Bailey, you mind standing up just for a second? So let's give them a round of applause. And then Melissa Collins, she did, we had boom whackers in the songs, and we had the recorder sounded beautiful, and let's give her a round of applause as well. In just a moment, the kids are going to be dismissed to their classes, and then you're going to follow to welcome them there, and they've got a lot to show you. I want to introduce you to Ashley Larmer and Sharon Davidson, and they've got all those cards, and in just a moment, Ashley's actually going to pull a name out of the hat, and we have a gift basket right by the piano that we're going to give out. Oh, are there any other cards? Oh, well, let's get those cards real quick. We just got a couple more. Somebody just handed me about 10 cards. I don't know if that was from the whole row or just them. But we are going to pull just one name out of the hat in just a moment. Now, this is our first of two performances. If you come tomorrow, you can fill out a card again. We're going to give out a gift basket one more time. I'm going to let Ashley pull the name out of the hat, and she's going to announce it.
Mr. and Mrs. John Korn.
You guys, there we are, right there. All right, right. Mr. and Mrs. John Korn. You guys, come on down. We'll give you a basket. There you go. Thank you so much for being here. They did a fantastic job. Let's give them another round of applause. It's such a special day. Again, Merry Christmas, and thank you for being here.